Well, students, in the previous lecture, we had talked about the three-level pumping scheme, wherein there were three energy levels, E1, E2, and E3. And we had seen how population inversion is achieved. And we also seen the drawback of this three-level pumping scheme was that it required very high pumping power, because to achieve population inversion, we had to take a huge number of the ground state atoms, that is more than half the ground state atoms, and put them into the metastable state E2. So that required a huge amount of energy. So today we're going to see how this drawback of requiring huge pumping power is taken care by the four level pumping scheme. So in the four level pumping scheme, as the name suggests, there are four energy levels. E1 is the ground state. E2 is a normal excited state above the ground state. E3 is a metastable state above the level E2. So E3 is metastable. And finally, E4 is the pumping level, highest energy level, uppermost energy level. So E1 is the ground state. E2 is a normal excited state. This is not a metastable state. E3 is a metastable state. And E4 is a normal excited state, also called as the pumping level. So in the beginning, as usual, before we start the process of pumping, the ground state energy level E1 is highly populated. There are some negligible number of atoms in the levels E2, E3 or E4. So here it is highly populated. So then through the process of optical pumping, that is by supplying photons, light, having frequency, having energy h nu equal to E4 minus E1, we initially take the atoms from the ground state E1 and take them to the level E4, pumping level E4. Okay, so energy required for this is, pumping energy required is E4 minus E1. So then, atoms which are taken to the level E4, E4 is a normal excited state, atoms cannot remain here for long. So, the atoms from E4, they have three options available to them. The first option is, they return back to the ground state through a spontaneous emission, or they drop into the level E2, which is a normal excited state, again through spontaneous emission. So these are both spontaneous emissions shown by straight downwards arrows. And the third option available is the atoms from level E4, they drop into the metastable state E3 through a non-radiative transition. So this is the transition in which the atom comes from the level E4 to E3 without emitting a photon, non-radiative transition. Now, since E3 is metastable, there will be an accumulation of atoms over here, because atoms can stay in this level for a long time since it is a metastable state. Similar accumulation of atoms will not happen in the level E2, because E2 is a normal excited state. It is not a metastable state. So here there is accumulation of atoms. So whatever atoms fall over here will remain over here for a long time. Whatever atoms fall over here will not remain for a long time, because this is not a metastable state. So there is accumulation of atoms here, there is no accumulation of atoms here. So within a very short duration of time, we will achieve a state wherein there are more atoms in the level E3 than the level E2. So population inversion is achieved between E3 and E2. Please note, important, that even after the process of pumping, the ground state E1 is still the most populated state. So what does it mean is that, we have not taken a very huge number of atoms from the ground state and put them into the level upper levels to achieve population inversion. We have taken just a few numbers. For example, suppose there were total number of atoms in the beginning 100, and initially all of them were in the ground state. Now to achieve population inversion, suppose we have just taken 20 atoms and put them up. Now out of these 20 atoms, let us say 15 fall into the metastable state and 5 are there in the non-metastable state E2. So even then we have achieved population inversion, because 15 over here and 5 over here is population inversion. But remember, 15 here and how many remain here? We have taken 20 up, so remaining here are 80. So 15 here and 80 here, we have not achieved population inversion between E3 and E1. So in four level pumping scheme, our aim is not to achieve population inversion between the metastable state and the ground state, but our aim is to achieve population inversion between the metastable state and the non-metastable state E2. So this doesn't require huge amount of energy, because by nature atoms will not remain here. There is no accumulation here, there is accumulation. So very easily number of atoms here will become more than number of atoms here. So So we have achieved population inversion between E3 and E2. And then to start the process of laser, so laser also occurs as shown by this thick arrow here. It also occurs between the levels between which population inversion is achieved, that is E3 and E2. But then for the laser to start, we require one starting photon. And how much should be the energy of this starting photon? It should be E3 minus E2, because the laser transition is occurring between E3 and E2. So where does this starting photon come from? As I had mentioned in the three level pumping scheme, the starting photon comes from a spontaneous emission, which occurs between E3 and E2. How does that happen? Remember, E3 is metastable. So atoms over here can remain for a long time, but not infinite time. So after some time, at least one of the atoms from the level E3 on its own will fall into the level E2 through spontaneous transition, and it will give rise to a spontaneously emitted photon having energy E3 minus E2. Now this spontaneously emitted photon then may go and collide with excited atoms in the level E3 and force them to come down to the level E2, giving rise to stimulated emissions, and that will produce two photons, and these two photons again may go and collide and force more atoms to come down, giving rise to 4 and 8 and 16 and so on. So huge number of identical photons will be created, giving rise to laser. So four level pumping require very high pumping power. So that's the advantage of it. It doesn't require very high pumping power here, because we are achieving population inversion not between E3 and E1, but we are achieving population inversion between metastable state E3 and the non-metastable state, normal excited state, that is E2. So this doesn't require a huge number of atoms to be taken up through the process of pumping. A few number of atoms taken up will achieve population inversion between E3 and E2. So pumping energy required is less. So four level pumping scheme is better than the three level pumping scheme because it requires less pumping power. So that was about the three level and four level pumping scheme. We have seen that the four level pumping scheme is better. Now, what is common in both these pumping schemes is that both of them, whether it's three level or four level, they have at least one metastable state. So metastable state is required whether it's three level or four level pumping scheme. Now, what is the necessity? Why is the metastable state so important in a laser system? So what is the necessity of a metastable state? Now, we know that light amplification occurs only once population inversion is achieved. But then to achieve population inversion, the metastable helps in doing it. So why? Because in a metastable state, atoms can remain for a longer time. So atoms get accumulated in the metastable state, and this helps in achieving population inversion. And population inversion is necessary for light amplification. So therefore, metastable state is required in a laser system. It is required in the process of light amplification. So without at least one metastable state, laser will not occur. Thank you.